I already know what you're thinking. These are the exact two tractors I'm trying to figure out. Which one do I want? Well, guess what? You can get either one of them right now at goodworkstractors.com. I very rarely get an X7 series in stock. I do have one right now. This is a beautiful example. It comes with a snowblower and a plow as well. I also have two of these 1025Rs with Mauser cabs on them. So check out goodworkstractors.com. A couple years ago, one of my first videos was a really crappy X7 versus 1025R video that I did. The audio was terrible. Maybe this one will be a little bit less crappy. But I want to tell you all about the X7 series versus the 1 series. This is going to be really my opinion. I will sprinkle in some actual differences between the two along with some similarities, but I've had a lot of experience personally. I've owned an X7 series, several of them, as well as 1025Rs, so I got a lot of insight here that hopefully can help you out. But I don't want you to take my word for it. Read the comment section below, okay? We have a lot of great viewers here, a lot of great input. It's a very welcoming community, so leave a comment below if you have a question too. But if you have insight into your own decision between an X7 series and a 1 series, let us know about it below. Let us know what you think, and let me know what I forgot to mention. I've gone back and forth multiple times between each one of these models here, an X7 series, a 1 series, okay? It's really, you know, it's totally personal preference depending on what you're going to be using it for. If you want a front end loader, get yourself a 1 series. If you just want to mow and move snow, that kind of thing, get yourself an X7. So my opinion is the fact that, you know what, for the best bang for the buck, the 1 series is where it's at. The X7, beautiful, wonderful machine. You know, I love using it. I had an X739. I'll put a link to the playlist. I've got a playlist actually for X739 and the 1025R, my own, the things that I've done with them, okay? So they're very good machines, both of them. I really like them. They have their place. If I was only gonna buy one though, it would be the 1025R over any of the X7 series options for my needs, okay? So that could be totally different based on what you wanna use it for. However, the biggest reason, money. Well, that's gonna be almost a wash, almost mind-blowing how close in price they really are. I'm gonna get into that right now. I'm gonna give you four prices here, so stay with me, okay? X738 base model with a 54-inch deck, drive-over deck, manual connect PTO, $13,049. Step up to the diesel version, the X758, again, includes a 54-inch drive-over mower deck. That's just how the MSRP, the base model, is on John Deere's website. $14,629, roughly $2,600 more for the diesel upgrade. John Deere 1023E, the basic version of the 1 series tractor. Tractor by itself, no loader, no mower, no anything, $12,672. 1025R, no loader, no mower, no anything, $14,627. Okay, so the most expensive, including a mower deck, is gonna be the X758, the diesel version, four-wheel drive, with a mower deck on there, $14,629. The cheapest version is going to actually be the 1023E, no mower deck though, but $12,672. I get it. There's a mower deck included in the X7 series quote, the base price. There's not one in the 1 series, okay? So you're talking maybe a minimum of, I don't know, $2,200, $2,300, $2,400, you know, if it's a manual connect PTO, not an auto connect PTO, but it's still gonna be a drive over deck. So kind of use that as your rough ballpark there for a minimum cost if you're looking at it. Like my dad always used to say, I'm hard on you because I love you, okay? So I'm not gonna stop telling you about this lube shuttle. Grease, okay? The most important way to protect your machine. Why? Because it's the one thing they have to do most often on your machine. Keep it greased, okay? And if you have an easy way to do that, not dealing with one of those traditional grease guns that leak all over the place, you can see it right here. What's it say? Rethink greasing. No plunger to pull back, no air gaps, no leaking grease, no wasted grease, no wasted time. You've got the steel cover on the top there. You undo that, you take it off, that's just to protect it, you know, and you got grease tubes here, all right? You can see there's no grease leaking out there, there's no mess here at all. You just take it off and you need to replace it. You can even refill these things if you want, but you get 5% off, discount code GWT. I'm telling you, grease is your friend, okay? So put it on there, take care of it, go to the description below in the video or go to my website, you'll see where you can buy this stuff, get 5% off, discount code GWT.
For as close to an apples to apples comparison as we can get, we're gonna take the John Deere X758, which would be the diesel version of the X7 series, okay? Versus the John Deere 1025R, which is kind of the fancy, okay? The fancy 1 series. Now you can get the 1023E for, what do we say? Oh, roughly $2,000 less or so. So keep that in mind. So MSRP is within $2 of the same price, okay? But bear in mind, you do get that mower deck on the X7 series. Not on the 1 series. So let's call it, let's just say it's $2,500 in real actual difference there, just for a round number. So what do you get for $2,500 when you go up to a 1025R over an X758. I've got a list of 10 things right here that you get when you go up to a 1025R that you don't get on an X758. I'm sure this isn't the entire list, so just put a comment below on what I forgot or what I got wrong, okay? Well, number one, you're getting more weight, okay? So you're paying for more weight, but you're getting more weight. Roughly 400 pounds more weight, okay? You have about 1,440 pounds here, base weight of the tractor, versus 1,038 for the X758. I like rhymes. So what does that mean? You know, with that extra weight, you're getting a beefier front axle, a beefier rear axle there, just a beefier chassis all around, all right? You're also gonna get included a rear PTO and a three-point hitch. So if you wanna run a tiller, or if you wanna run a box blade or a little brush hog or whatever it might be, you're already gonna be set up on the one series to be able to do that versus having to pay, you know, the additional, what is it? Is it around $1,500 now, I think, to add on a rear PTO and a three-point hitch to an X7 series? So you can see right there, that gap starts to shrink. You're gonna have a high and low range here on the 1025R. You're not gonna be able to select that on the X7 series. It's just hydrostat. You just go forward and reverse. You have that ability to change that on the 1025. A few other things as well, okay? You're gonna get a toolbox included, an actual toolbox where you can store some tools in it. You're gonna get work lights on there, fender mounted work lights. You're gonna get a ROP system, a rollover protection system. Unless you get a cab on it, then that might be a little bit different. You're going to get a loader joystick as well instead of a couple levers there. So if you do add on a loader, or even if you add on a front plow or a snowblower, that kind of thing, you still have one joystick there to maneuver and manipulate versus a couple of handles. And you're obviously going to have a little bit bigger footprint all around here. You can see just the stature of it. It sits a little bit higher. That can be a downside. I know some guys want or need as low a center of gravity as possible, especially if they're on hills, that kind of thing. So I'm going to see if I can get you a measurement on that later too. So if you really kind of think about all that extra stuff you get for $2,500 ballpark, you know, that's a pretty reasonable upgrade. And you know what I'm gonna tell you? Those one series hold their value a lot better than an X7 series does, because you can do so much more over time with a one series. So seriously, if you got a 1023E with that 54-inch mower deck on there, manual connect, I wouldn't be surprised if you could get that for just within a few bucks of the cost of an X758 with that same 54-inch mower deck. You know, just all the features that it has, all the potential that it has with the rear three-point hitch and the front end loader and that kind of thing too, versus you're kind of restricted on the X7 series, you know. And if you get a gas engine in here, well, first of all, those things are gas hogs. I mean, I'm telling you, that's the one thing that I hated so much about my X7 series was how often I had to fill it up with fuel. It just ran through it, where one of these 1025Rs, the same thing with the X758, you know, if you get the diesel version, they're just gonna go all day long on a tank of fuel. So by going to the one series, there's a couple things you can get that you just simply can't get on the X7 series. One of them is gonna be a backhoe, all right? The other one's gonna be a front end loader. On the flip side, there's a couple things you can get in the X7 that you cannot get in the one series. That would be the all-wheel steer, so you can literally, the X739, those rear wheels turn as well as the front wheels. That's the model I had. I absolutely loved it. It was great for my yard with mowing. It was also great for snow plowing in my driveway too. You can turn on a dime there. It's not a zero turn, but it is really close. You can get a gasoline engine in the X7, diesel only here in the one series. The X7 series models that are four-wheel drive, so we have the X738, the X739, and the X758, those are going to be full-time four-wheel drive. There's no ability to put it into two-wheel drive. The older versions of it, like the X728, X729, X748, and X749, yes, there used to be a diesel all-wheel steer. There's no longer that diesel all-wheel steer option available, but those were actually a manual. You could engage or disengage the four-wheel drive. Not able to do that now with the newer generation. Over on the one series though, you can engage and disengage two or four wheel drive whenever you need it. They're both going to have that locking rear differential on top of that, but that's a big difference there. Let's run down through a list of similarities here, okay? So they're both going to have a very nice suspension seat on them. I will say, come standard with armrests over here on the 1025R, not so over here on the X7. It is an upgrade though. But I gotta mention that the 1023E, the base model in the one series, does come with a very plain Jane, not much of a suspension seat. Just keep that in mind. Your tires are gonna be the exact same sizes on both the fronts and the backs for the X7 and the one series. They're gonna be 18 by 8.5s on the fronts and 26 12/12s on the back. I've done some videos showing those new Carlisle VersaTurfs. I absolutely love those. The only radial option that's available right now. You can get them on here. You can get them on either one of these models. It doesn't matter. Mid-mount mowers, you're going to have an ability to put a 60-inch or a 54-inch on either one of these machines here. There's no 72s, there's no 48s, as far as I know. But I will say that the 54 and the 60 is a pretty different construction on the 1 Series, where the 54s and 60s are a little bit more similar construction when you're on the X7 Series garden tractors. I think these mow amazingly well. They do a really, really good job. I also think that the 1 Series mows really well too, but you know, that's one of those big things below where you'll get some feedback and some user comments on. But that's something that there is a wide-ranging matter of opinion on, that between what has a really good quality cut and what doesn't. So maybe check out the forums or look at the comments below. Leave your comment as well if you have the experience. Interesting enough, you're going to be able to get the same exact bagger setups on both the X and the 1. You can get cabs on both of these machines here as well. You're going to have heat only. Air conditioning is not an option, but you can take the doors. They just kind of pop up and off pins that are on either side here. So you can basically treat it like a sun canopy in the summertime, get that airflow that you need so you're not stifling hot inside. However, this Mauser cab right here, that's only available on the 1 Series. It's not going to be an option right now on the X7 Series, to the best of my knowledge. Let's go ahead and grab a few dimensions here for you really quick. We're going to just do outside to outside of the tires. Approximately 45 inches or so, maybe just a hair underneath that, outside to outside. For our wheelbase, we're going to take center of axle to center of axle, and we're looking at 56 inches here. I promised you that seat height as well, so we're going to do our best guess here, the eyeball test, to the top of the seat cushion here, which looks to be about 37 inches. Let's do the same thing here in the 1 Series. The rear tires here, outside to outside, you're going to be approximately 47, 48 inches. We're just gonna call it 48 because it's 4 foot, but it's just a hair underneath that. And just for the record, I did just double check that rear outside to outside dimension on the X7. It was about 46 inches, so slightly bigger than the front. So what the heck, we'll go ahead and measure the front outside to outside on the 1 Series 2, about 45 inches. I think that was right about what the X7 was too. Let's get that wheelbase again, okay? Center of axle to center of axle. Again, this is a ballpark, not rocket science here, just keeping things simple. You're about 56 inches. Wasn't that the same as the X7? Lastly, we'll do that eyeball test here to the top of the seat cushion. Right in there, you're gonna be approximately 39 inches. So a couple inches higher on the 1 Series versus the X7. Well, we're wrapping up just as they're getting started mowing next door there, so sorry for the background noise, but hopefully this helps give you a little bit better insight into an X7 Series versus a 1 Series. This is not all-encompassing, okay? I missed things. I intentionally did not make this 45 minutes long, so if you have a question, leave it below. If I don't get back to you, hopefully somebody else will as well. Also, you can get more information. You'll see a lot of information on a place like Green Tractor Talk, which is a forum full of John Deere owners, okay? So they're very helpful over there as well. I'd encourage you to check it out. If you haven't done so yet, hit that subscribe button right underneath the video. Make sure you check out the other videos on my channel. Make sure you read through that description as well, right underneath the video, okay? I put a lot of helpful links down there to my website, to my Amazon store, to places that you can get 5% off with discount code GWT, so make sure you check it out. Well, until next time, stay safe. We'll see you soon.